because we're now working in an open space. People are not talking to each other anymore. So one of the things I do every day is I tour the open space, and I speak very loudly with everybody just to make sure that people know that it's okay to speak, it's okay to talk to each other. You don't have to communicate by email with your neighbor. I'm a trained engineer in biotechnology, and when I graduated, there was a big economic crisis in Europe and there were no jobs whatsoever. So the first job I could find, which was vaguely related, was one on chemical safety. The person who hired me thought that as a risk assessors for chemicals, you needed to know about biology and chemistry. And so I was a biotechnologist. That sounded vaguely like something that would be useful. So that's why I got hired. You may have seen that certainly in Europe and many other countries, products have safety labels now. And these labels and the criteria for applying those labels were developed at the OECD. The problem that all countries have is that there are about 100,000 chemicals on the market, and there are about 1,000 new chemicals that are being put on the market every year. Assessing the safety of those chemicals is very resource intensive. Writing a risk assessment, assuming that all the data is available that you need, can take up to 2-3 years. No country can do this on their own. Why don't we pull all our resources together and develop a toolbox, a computer software system, where everybody contributes their tools and we make it a coherent system that regulators and companies can use to assess the toxicity of their chemicals. And that is a program that I was very lucky to start. It's one of the flagship projects that we have at the OECD. We were once invited at a dinner with one of the ambassadors of the OECD. And the ambassador said, "Why are you working on chemical safety at the OECD?" And everybody answered, "To save the environment and to save human health." And the ambassador said, "But that's not what the OECD does." The reason why this is at the OECD, because it's a resource issue. Working together at the OECD, you manage to reduce the costs for ensuring the safety of chemicals. If we all use the same methodologies, then the work done in Germany can be reused in the US and vice versa. The zero risk chemical does not exist. The problem is always that, I mean, these chemicals were designed not because of their toxicity, but because they have a function. They have been put on the market for their function. If you have a chemical that functions very well and that turns out to be problematic for human health, to replace it with a chemical that is less hazardous and has the same function is not easy. Per and polyfluorinated chemicals, they are both water and oil repellent. Your textiles don't stain anymore. They're fantastically functional, but they're very, very difficult to replace. It's impossible to find chemicals that have the same functionality. Having said that, replacing hazardous chemicals with less hazardous chemicals should always be possible.